in the kitchen to learn how to make a refreshing and unique summer cocktail.
Our teacher today is Jay Cavanaugh, the assistant liquor manager at the Table and Vine flagship store in West Springfield. It's a wonderful store with an extensive variety of beer, wine, and even specialty foods.
Yeah, it's right over the border. It's nice to be here. It's Jake's pleasure to see you.
Pleasure to be here.
All right, so we're making a watermelon mojito today.
That we are.
Well, Karen and I have this question. I really don't know what's in a regular mojito.
A regular mojito is going to be mint, lime, rum, and a little bit of simple syrup.
And you got to crush it and do that.
You're going to be muddling with this little guy right here.
Muddling.
Bruising the mint leaves a little bit, releases the aromas and some of the oils, but not too much. You don't want to go too crazy.
Okay.
If you muddle too intensely, it releases bitter oils that you don't want. So just a little bit. Nothing crazy.
I didn't realize that.
I didn't actually know. Sometimes I was just putting mint in a drink and wondering why it didn't taste like mint. I didn't know you have to do something to it.
You got
to
bruise it up a little bit. A lot of times people will just take it and kind of rub it in their hand or slap it just to break the veins in there a little bit. But so we're gonna be making the cocktail in a shaker today.
Okay.
So first you need... For one, it would be the juice of one lime, but I'm making three of them, so we're going to...
Oh, three of them. Two for me and one for you, Jake.
So you're going to juice that lime.
Kara's got to work a little later today. And Table and Vine is a Big Y company.
Correct, yes. We are owned by Big Y.
Which is terrific. And Kara's
holding
a wonderful...
Look at these cute magazines. Okay, I didn't know. I guess we get these right when we walk in.
Yep, they're available at every Big Y.
Okay, and at the Table and Vine source. And then if you look in here, this is the recipe I opened up to page where we're going to learn how to make the watermelon mojito.
Which is terrific. I didn't even know that. I'm going to go to my local Big Y and muddle my way through the aisles. All right, so that's a lot of work there you're doing.
It's a little better when it's fresh, right? It's worth it.
If you need us to do anything, please let us know. Kara's looking to do something.
All right, well, like I said, we're going to build this in the shaker. So we're going to take, it's around 10 mint leaves for a single drink. I'm making three, so I got a little bit more in there, so I'll throw those in there.
So those go in first because now you're going to muddle them?
Yep. Well, I'm going to add the watermelon, the lime, and the mint, muddle that up.
Muddle
them together, commingled in a nice one big happy family.
Muddle all together. Now don't be shy.
Take the watermelon.
And the watermelon will be easy to do because I'm sure it's easy to mush and it's juicy.
Yeah, it's very soft and gooey.
Would you do this with a different fruit too if like you wanted another variation?
You would generally muddle a lime. But same deal with the lime as with the mint. You don't want to muddle a lime too intensely because the rind has some oils that are unenjoyable.
But if you don't like watermelon, can you do peach?
There's no rules.
You can trade this out for any kind of fruit. The watermelon mint sound amazing, but I guess you could have different varieties.
This is the white rum. You need white rum for
white
a mojito. I like the Captain Morgan white rum. It's five times distilled. Every time you distill something, it becomes a little bit more pure.
And speaking of the Captain, for those of you who wondered what that big red blotch was on the top of my head a little earlier, I banged my head on Captain Dave's boat the other day while we were doing a story, and I clocked my head. So it's dried, and I do apologize for showing that to you. I didn't even realize it was there. But it was like, boom!
I didn't know either. You bent down. I'm like, no, that's fresh. I know that was a few days ago, but something's happened.
All right, anyway, this Captain, I should put this right on my scalp, shouldn't I?
No.
It might sting a little. I don't know if I'd want to do that.
And the infusion right into my veins. All right, so you're muddling.
Just muddling a little bit. You don't want to go in too intense.
What is that called that you buy? Do you buy one of those?
It's a muddler. You could use a wooden spoon. Anything works. This is specifically designed for making cocktails, but anything works.
If you just were using a wooden spoon at home,
yeah, everybody's got a wooden spoon at home, so that works perfectly fine.
Okay.
All right, so we got the rum, the lime, the mint, and the watermelon in the shaker. Give it a good shake. Just gotta get that all blended up and good.
Gotta do it. It's more fun when you play along.
So then we gotta throw a little bit of ice in each of these glasses.
So that small shaker makes three drinks. I didn't know that. It seems
We're gonna put a little bit of the spirit watermelon and lime concoction into each glass.
We only have about 30 seconds. You wanna just make one and we'll just sip it?
Sure, sounds good.
And talk a little bit more about the magazine for us.
The magazine has all kinds of specials throughout the stores. Like, for example, this recipe is in the store or in the magazine this month. So what you're going to do is you strain it right into the glass.
Look at how beautiful that is.
And you kind of have to work it a little bit because
the muddling of
all the mint and watermelon that's in there is trying to jam it up.
And then you're going to add some sort of a lemon lime soda. You're using Sprite.
Yep,
but we
I'm using
use...
Sprite today, but you can use whatever your favorite brand is.
Okay. Now, if you're trying to lessen your sugar or something, could you just do seltzer water or taste it?
Sure.
Okay.
You could,
or lemon lime seltzer.
Yeah. All right.
Zero.
It's very pretty.
Give it a swig. For more information, you can visit tableandvine.com. They're located on Riverdale Street in West Springfield, Massachusetts. We so appreciate you coming in. Oh, look at that. It's
like
orange with
your pretty.
It's very light and fresh.
All right. You read this.
Delicious.
And I'll take this.
All right.